In the U.S., senators advance what would be the country's first major gun control legislation in decades. The lawmakers voted to speed up the passage of the bill, meaning it could be put to a vote in the chamber by the end of the week. It cleared the procedural hurdle by 64 to 34, with 14 Republicans backing the bill. Only 60 votes are needed for the bill's final passage. The measure includes tougher background checks for gun buyers younger than 21. It also provides $15 billion in new funding for mental health programs and school security upgrades. President Joe Biden has said, although the proposal is a step in the right direction, it's still not enough. The measure comes amid a spate of mass shootings in the U.S. An update now on the fatal shooting of a Filipino lawyer in Philadelphia. The city government is offering a $20,000 reward for information that would lead to the arrest of the shooter. Philadelphia Mayor Jim Kenney on Tuesday met with the family of Don Lilo. He assured them justice will be served. Lilo's remains will be repatriated to the Philippines next week.
Gusto ko pong iuwi para po sa pamilya namin. Marami po naghihintay sa kanya. Napakarami po. Marami pong nagawang mabuti po itong anak. Kaya,
At saka bata
po,
pa ho.
Nakakapanghinayang. Nakakapanghinayang. Dami po niyang dreams, dami niyo pong plano. Gusto ko na magkaroon po ng justice kasi po hindi po namin deserve nung yung ganito.
The U.S. appalled by the Kremlin's suggestion the two American citizens captured while fighting for Ukraine could face execution. In an interview with NBC News Monday, Kremlin spokesperson Dmitry Peskov said the two Americans were endangering Russian soldiers and should be held accountable for those crimes. When pressed on what crimes were committed, Peskov admitted the specifics were not yet known, but he claimed these would not be covered by the Geneva Conventions on Prisoners of War.
It's appalling that a public official in Russia would even suggest the death penalty for two American citizens that were in Ukraine. Whether they actually mean what they're saying here and that this could be an outcome, that they could levy a death penalty against two Americans that were fighting in Ukraine, or that they just feel it's a responsible thing for a major power to do, to talk about doing this as a way of signaling the President of the United States and the American people. Either one of them is equally alarming, and that's why, again, we find it appalling.
The interview marked the first time Moscow has commented on the case of the two U.S. military veterans. They're believed to have joined other foreigners who have volunteered to fight Russia's invasion. Other news now, U.S. President Joe Biden says he plans to talk with his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping as he considers lifting some tariffs imposed on Beijing in a bid to bring down inflation. Biden says there's no schedule yet, but the talks could happen soon. The last meeting between the two leaders was March 18, when Biden warned Xi against assisting Russia in its invasion of Ukraine. The Trump administration imposed 25% duties on billions of dollars worth of Chinese imports during a damaging trade war, which began in 2018. The penalties were aimed at punishing what the U.S. says are China's unfair trade practices. The tariffs are set to expire in July unless renewed. The CEO of ExxonMobil says consumers must be prepared to endure up to 5 years of turbulent oil markets. ExxonMobil's Darren Woods says this should prompt governments to think long term because the volatility will take time to end, which means crude prices may continue to rise. Meanwhile, representatives from the Middle East energy industry also renewed calls for better planning in consumer countries. Energy markets have been roiled by the Ukraine war as Russia has reduced some exports and faced sanctions.